Today we are going to start our new topic, that is wedding. Our lesson which is going on, that is crop protection, and the things which we have studied, that are various steps used for the agriculture. So various steps, first of all, first thing, preparation of the soil, we have read out. The second step, adding manure and fertilizer, that we have studied, that we have read out. The third step, sowing the seed, that also we have studied. The fourth step, the last step which we have studied, that is irrigation. In irrigation, I have told you there are two types of irrigation, two methods of the irrigation. Number one, traditional method, and number two, modern method. In traditional method, I have given you 6 examples, and modern method, I have told you about the 2 examples. Means how we are irrigating our crop, how we are watering our field. So this is the thing which I am telling you. Now we are going to start our new topic, that is weeding. And weeding, if we are talking about the topic weeding, that means we should know first about the weed. So the first thing is there, what is weed? The unwanted and undesired plants are grown in the middle of the crop. That is called weed. So those plants which are not required for us, suppose we are growing up the crop of wheat, right? So in that, suppose amaranthus is grown, right? Amaranthus is grown, and suppose that in that Chenopodium is grown, right? Amaranthus and Chenopodium is grown in middle of that, right? So that means I do not need them, but they are grown in the middle of the crop. Now what will happen? They will be called weeds, right? For removing them, for cutting them, that purpose is called weeding. That process is called weeding. The next term which we are going to do, that is weeding. The removal of unwanted and undesired plants from the crop. That is called the process of removal of unwanted and undesired plant from the crop. That is called weeding, right? So removal of these kind of plants manually, that process is called weeding. So the next question which comes why we require wheat, why the wheat's grown, and why do not we require, and why weeding process is required. Indirectly, I can say like this, that why the weeding is needed. Need of process weeding. Okay. See, suppose crops are grown. Right? Now, along with them, weeds are also grown. Along with them, weeds are also grown. Right? Now, crop require sunlight, water, CO2, nutrients, etc. for growth and development, right? And weed use the water and nutrient given to crop. और जो भी चीजें आप क्रॉप के लिए दे रहे हो या क्रॉप के लिए खर्च कर रहे हो, ऑल दोस थिंग्स आर यूज्ड बाय वीट. नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन, योर क्रॉप विल बिकम वीक एंड वीट विल बिकम हेल्दी. राइट? सपोज खाना आप बनाओ और पड़ोसी का है, सो व्हाट विल हैपन, यू विल बिकम वीक ना, एंड द नेबर्स विल बिकम स्ट्रॉन्ग. ए सेम मैनर है, वी डू नॉट रिक्वायर वीट्स, बट दे आर यूजिंग अवर वाटर, दे आर यूजिंग अवर न्यूट्रिएंट्स, दे आर यूजिंग द सनलाइट एंड इंक्रीजिंग कॉम्पिटिशन फॉर एब्जॉर्बिंग द things. That's why it is necessary to remove the weeds from the middle of the crops. Right? So, what is the need of process weeding? Answer is here. To reduce the competition among our crop and weeds for water, sunlight, CO2 and nutrients. What we do? We just take them out. We just destroy them. Right? So, our crop will get complete nutrients, whatever we are providing. Right? So, competition will be reduced. Now, see, which are the things which are used as a weeds, which are grown, which are already by itself only, they are grown in the field, in the middle of the crop. Example of wheat like amaranthus. Right? Second thing, Chenopodium. right? For example, amaranthus, we are calling it chaurai, eaten by animals. Who are eating them? Animals. Chiropodium, Bathua, you have listened to Bathua. That Bathua, which we are eating, making Bathua ke parathe and all. So, for that purpose, that is Chiropodium. We are not spreading the seed of Chiropodium in the middle of the wheat crop. Automatically, it is dropped. Automatically, it is getting the water of the crop and just growing. Right? Wild oats. Wild oats means jungli wo ug jate hai na, wo oats se ug jate hai. That is called wild oats. So these are the things why we require to remove weeds from the middle of our crop. Now the weeds can be removed manually. Weeds can be removed manually. Right? How they can be removed manually? They can be removed manually with the help of two things. Number one, trowel. Number two, harrow. Trowel. Number two, harrow. And how it is possible? Trowel, you know, that one, khurpi. Right? And harrow, used as a cultivator in tractors. Right? They are just digging out all the grass, extra grass grown in the field. Right? That is harrow. So both the things are used to remove the weeds manually. Now I am going to tell you the name of some weedicides. Some weedicides are example of weedicides. Chemicals. If we are putting them, spraying them into the field, then the weeds are not grown in the field. So the first weedicide name is cymegine, and the second one is metalocella, and the third one is butaclore. It is the third one, butaclore, and they are used as a weedicides in our fields. These are the chemicals to whom we are using in our field, and we are just trying to remove the weeds, unwanted, undesired plants from our from our fields or from the middle of the crop. So these are the things which I have told you today. Try to learn them, try to understand them. Now today I am giving you the homework. Try to find out the answer of all of them, and the questions will be from the things which I have told you, which I have given the lecture today. Homework. Question number one. What do you mean by wedding. Question number 2. Why do we remove the weeds from our field? Right? Question number 3. Name 2 chemicals which are used as weedicides. Next, question 4. Give 2 examples. Give the name of two examples of weed. So that's enough for today. Try to solve these questions. You will find the answer in today's lecture only. Thank you. Thank you very much, class.